So hey, Ronnie, check it out. I got one of the Walmart blades that everybody was trying to get, right? One that's kind of orange. Well, it looks cool and all, and I haven't opened it yet, but I think I'm going to go ahead and dye the handle because it looks kind of like this. I'm not too keen on this orange. So I'm thinking I'm going to add some green, maybe make it like a brown. Anyway, stick around.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter.
Peanut butter, peanut. Okay, so here's the knife. I'm going to use this. Some good old Rit dye. And I'm going to dye it in this. This used to be a jelly jar. Should be good, right? This is a camera mount that I probably should be using. But from what I've read, you can use this, a little bit of vinegar and some salt. And it should do maybe a good job of dyeing these plastic scales. I've seen some pretty decent results, so I'm hoping that I will have them too. So I'm going to dye the knife using a couple simple ingredients. I'm going to use some Rit dye. This is a liquid stuff. This is a super hot cup of water. It was boiling a few minutes ago. Now it's not. Careful with that. A drop of soap. And you can set dye with these things a couple different ways. For synthetic material, you probably want to use vinegar, which is what I'm doing, but people have used salt, I guess, with some results. Look at that. I didn't even know that was in there. Sweet. All right, here we go. Got the knife. Oh, look at that. Not gonna lie, it is a nice feeling knife. Yeah, this thing for 10 bucks is amazing. It's not squishy. I got a couple of these, believe it or not. All right, so there's the super hot water. I'm gonna go ahead and actually use the measuring cup, not for the dye. I'm gonna use a measuring cup for the vinegar. I'm gonna do about a third of a cup or a quarter cup. Let's see how accurate I was. Good enough. I think a third is probably a little too much. Sorry, I'm going to go ahead and add that. Hopefully it doesn't overflow my jar. Ooh, it's close. Nice. And then I'm going to do the Rit dye. Nice. It's pretty far up there. All right, so we've got the vinegar, we've got the dye. I need a drop of soap. That ought to work. I do need to give it a little stir, kind of mix it before I dunk the knife. I'll be honest with you, when I wasn't gonna make a video about this and just do it, I was just gonna stir it with the knife. So I think that's exactly what I'm gonna do now. So, if it, ready? Oh yeah, way too much. I knew that was going to happen. Let's see. Let's see what happens. I'm going to leave this in here for about 15 minutes. I did come prepared with some paper towels. And yeah, we'll see what happens. So here's the deal. I didn't really plan this out. I went and just grabbed some stuff and decided to give it a whirl. Because I've seen other people have some pretty good luck. But I will tell you, having a couple of these things so far, if this knife comes up again on Walmart, the Ozark Trail, near the D2 orange 7.5 inch folding knife, is it worth 10 bucks? Absolutely, all day long. So I would totally get it. All right, we'll be back. Let's see what it looks like when we're done. I don't know how successful this is going to be. All right, I got to fix this. I got to drain it a little bit. That's about right. That's the green color. Reason being is I want to add more dye. All right, now we can go away and come back. Okay. So realistically, it's actually been about 2 hours. And this is kind of what we're left with. Now it's more of a brick color than an orange color. So it didn't really turn green. And I also happen to notice that it looks like there may be a little bit of a crack right there. I don't know, some sort of blemish. I don't obviously expect much for being at $10. But I'm not displeased by the color. Let me wipe it off. Whoa. Get this out of the way. Because I kind of like it being more of a brick color. And sort of a happy coincidence, it actually matches this. This is a little pouch made with, I think it's called Dyneema. That I got a little while ago, just a little zipper pouch. Ultra light. That's pretty cool. That's not planned. That's just kind of what happened. And I'm totally fine with that. And I don't necessarily worry. I'm not too worried about that. That actually makes it even more individual to me. So I know that this is mine. No matter what. Like I could identify it now. So I will say that having all that vinegar with the dye and letting it sit has taken off some of the black paint on some of the knuts. And it did look like it sort of etched the blade slightly because vinegar is caustic. But that's okay. Overall, I'm all right with it. I bought this knife because everybody sort of hyped it up. But I fully plan on using it. So if this thing gets destroyed in the process of actually using it, I am absolutely okay with that. So, and besides, I have another one squirreled away just in case. Anyway, there you go. With some Rit dye, vinegar, and some soap and some hot water, you can make your knife look awful, just like I did. Or I can say, I decided I want to start carrying this little pouch and I wanted my knife to match, and that is pretty stinking close. All right, so this is where we're at. So this is the color that happened afterward, just to show you that it really did sort of change colors. Look at that. It doesn't quite match so much, does it? I'm not unhappy. I like it. So there. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, let me know. Do appreciate you taking time to watch the videos. Do me a favor, comment, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. It helps the channel. But yeah, see ya.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter.